So I was just in the ring with Conrad getting in, and normally there's an angrier, more ominous feel. He seems a little more laid back today. I don't know if he's focused or if he's under the weather or what, but he doesn't seem as aggressive as he normally does.
Seems like he's in his own head a little bit here.
Well, let's see if it works out to his advantage. Looks like a little wrist lock. He's got things going. Joey going for the ropes. Can't quite get there. Going for the ropes again. Conrad's really putting some torque on that left arm. And there's the ropes. He got there.
Maybe I was wrong about Conrad not being focused. He's off to a pretty strong start here.
Joey lingering around the ropes a little bit now. He's getting into it with the audience.
It's like he's trying to agitate Conrad, too, which in the past has been pretty easy to do.
Doesn't look like it's going to be super simple tonight. Joey going to the ropes again. Conrad, actually, I'm not sure if he's frustrated or if he's finding this a little entertaining.
I don't think Conrad can believe O'Reilly is acting like this right now, honestly.
There's that arrogance we were talking about. And Joey goes in, takes the back. Conrad breaking the grip. There it is. Looks like he's going back to that left arm, and it's a wrist lock, it looks like. And Joey right over the ropes again.
Conrad's been out wrestling him, but O'Reilly has an answer in the ropes every time.
Hey man, a good portion of the battle is ring presence, and he knows how close he is to those ropes.
I think now Joey O'Reilly is just trying to make Conrad more frustrated, get him flustered, take him off of his game a little bit, because so far...
And there's the boot to the midsection, headlock. Joey finally having his first advantage. Oh, he's thrown to the ropes. Both of them shoulders, and Joey out of the ring.
What O'Reilly is doing here is dictating the pace. He is not letting Conrad set the speed of this contest. And by doing that, every time Conrad gets the upper hand, he doesn't gain any momentum because O'Reilly gets out of the equation for a moment.
Whatever works, I guess. Riley rolling in so he doesn't get the count and rolling right back out. Conrad out of the ring. He's going after him. Coming around the corner, and Riley needs to watch his back. Forearm to the back. Throws Riley in the ring, goes in after him, and Riley run into the corner.
He got a little cocky there, and he paid the price.
Yep, Conrad dogging him in the corner. He's going to one corner. He's going to run to the other. Let's see what happens. Drop kick. Oh, man. Rolls backwards. Looks like Conrad's about to start working on that momentum. Double leg drop right to the midsection. Goes for the pin. Two count. Can't get it.
Conrad's finally gaining some ground here.
Yeah, it looks like that whole set and the pace thing wasn't working for Riley. Conrad with the headlock, putting some torque on it. Riley fighting him in the corner. And a forearm right to the chest. Was that the chest or the throat? Either way, it looks like it hurt.
That's one way to break the five count.
Throwing him up to the corner and a drop kick. Conrad falling off the turnbuckle.
Athletic wrestler.
That was pretty agile. And a moonsault. There it goes. It goes for the pin. One, two. Two count. Can't quite get it with the moonsault. Riley putting the foot on the throat of Conrad, trying to keep him from getting air. Jumping knee drop right to the chest. And again, Riley finally gaining some steam. Right into the back of the neck of Conrad. There's the pin, two count. Looks like Riley's trying to put this one away early.
This just goes to show that earlier in the match, O'Reilly wasn't escaping to the ropes and to the outside because he had to. He was only trying to get into the head of Conrad.
Joey with the snapmare. Ooh, drop kick to the back of the head.
As you can see here, Joey O'Reilly has no problem wrestling anyone standing up or on the ground. He can fly high, he can grapple, and he can strike.
Conrad looks about out of it after that drop kick to the back of the head. Leg drop. Ooh, Joey O'Reilly showing no mercy. Leg across the throat, keeping Conrad from getting air.
I can hear Conrad gagging for air right now. You can't do a whole lot if you can't breathe.
And the crowd getting behind Conrad. Conrad with the elbows fighting back. Arrow goes to the ropes, gets countered, and O'Reilly all over him.
The beatdown. You know, I don't know the last time I heard the crowd actually chanting for Conrad.
Man, I don't know what that says about Joey.
This is a rare occurrence.
Conrad in the corner, O'Reilly with the boot to the throat, making sure Conrad can't recover, and an uppercut right to that, and another one, haymaker after haymaker, right to Conrad's face.
Just like it's rare to hear Conrad as a fan favorite, it's also rare to see him on the receiving end of an aggressive attack like this. He's normally the one giving out the punishment this consistently.
And Joey O'Reilly showboating a little bit.
This is not the Conrad we've become accustomed to here in UWC.
Joey stepping right on the face. Man, this is looking bad for Conrad. He better do something.
He's just being tortured right now by O'Reilly.
Ooh, this is a pretty bad submission. Putting
twerking
some torque on
neck.
That shoulder and neck. Into a crossface. Conrad looking for the ropes, can't get there. Oh, he gets there. Look at that, gotta break the hold. Joey not letting go.
He's got the five count and he's going to use it to its fullest effect.
Joey arguing with the ref. He better stay on Conrad. Conrad's known to get aggressive. He hasn't been thus far, but that doesn't mean he won't turn.
He's been good at being aggressive so far, but all it takes is a few seconds.
Oh, kick right to the head, and Conrad folds over.
Conrad might be out cold.
Two count. Joey going for the pin again. Nope. Conrad folding back up to his knees.
Conrad is in a bad, bad way here. Whatever he had planned, he needs to change it.
And he goes under him. Conrad with the flying forearm. Joey back down to the ground. Conrad on the ground. Who's getting up first? Conrad's taking a considerable beating. I wouldn't be surprised if Joey doesn't get to his feet first.
Conrad needs to get up, and he needs to get up now. He has a lot of ground to cover to catch up to Conrad in this contest.
Looks like Conrad was the first to turn over, but Joey's stirring. Joey's back to his feet. This is bad. Conrad better do something. Joey with a hard right hand. Conrad in the corner.
Joey had the luxury of being able to take his time getting up because he knew Conrad was too beat up to get right up and get back on him.
Repeated right hands and forearms to Conrad in the corner. Conrad finally fighting back. One of the midsection throws Joey to the corner, throwing him to the other turnbuckle. Hits hard with a clothesline. Looks like he's going to the other turnbuckle again. Ooh, runs him face first into it. Joey flipping out of the and Conrad back to his feet as well. Both of them showing some athleticism, but turning around into a forearm from Joey O'Reilly.
But you can see the fatigue and the damage that Conrad has taken there. On the kip up, he wasn't able to really stick it. He's not doing anything cleanly at this point.
And Joey running forearm to Conrad in the corner. Spinning forearm and Conrad back to the ground.
Joey going for the pin, two, with that.
And three, that's it, that's over. Joey O'Reilly is our winner.
That wasn't the same Conrad that we're used to seeing tonight. And I don't think it was the better Conrad that we saw tonight either. Whatever he had tonight, it wasn't enough.
You know, I was an original here. Can you let me speak?
No one cares!
Every week, I came into this ring, and I wrestled. Yes. But you know what happened during that time span?
What?
I left UWC. Yeah. And I went on to accomplish great things. Things I accomplished in a week that you people will never accomplish in a lifetime.
Yeah.
Some heavy words of wisdom that were dropped on Conrad right now.
You did a good job, Conrad!
I think we're seeing a broken man right now. But the audience is still showing respect to him. This whole thing has been very strange to watch. And I don't know where Conrad goes from here.